I gotta say congratulations on Game of Thrones. You've won so many Emmys, it's the most awarded Emmy awarded show in history.
Yeah, I know, it's crazy.
I mean, you beat out Frasier.
I know, I can't believe it. I'm sure that, like, time when Kelsey Grammer went into the writer's room and said, we need some dragons.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We need more dragons.
We need more dragons.
Yeah. Is it true that your wife has never seen an episode of Game of Thrones?
I dragged her to the premiere of the first, and then since then, no. But she keeps promising that she'll sit down with a friend and watch it.
How is she getting away with this?
It's fine. I'm not. How can you can like say you gotta watch me?
No, yeah, that's
what. You can't do that.
That's what I tell my wife. I mean, I put it on. If she doesn't watch it at night, I put it on in the mornings. I go, hey, we gotta watch the show. We're having breakfast and watching it now.
Let's stream it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I want to talk about Small Crimes.
Yes.
It's on Netflix, which couldn't be a hotter thing. Oh my gosh, Netflix.
It's amazing. If a movie like that is just, you know, suddenly it's worldwide, 190 countries. It's a small, independent movie. We're so happy. We're lucky.
Yeah, and tell me about it, Small Crimes.
Well, it's about this guy, Joe Denton. He's a disgraced cop. He served six years in prison. He kind of tried to kill the local DA. But now he's
kind
coming.
Of,
he's,
yeah, well, maybe.
He,
well,
yeah,
you'll see, yeah.
In his world, he didn't. But now he's turned a corner, and he's going to, you know, you think it's a redemption story. And it is in the beginning, but, you know, it's difficult to change.
Oh yeah, I know.
And but it's a black comedy.
And it's based on a
novel, yeah, yeah. Small Crimes. And it was just an amazing script, great actors.
I heard you were a real diva on set. Really hard, really difficult, really demanding.
I was very demanding. Yeah, it was so embarrassing.
You got to tell the story. It's great.
Well, it's like this was a low budget movie. So everyone worked on scale, and we all, you know, work under the same conditions. Trailers were tiny, but we were all in this together. Now, my trailer, my dressing room, I mean, we were shooting in Montreal. It was so hot. The AC didn't work. They sent a guy over. It still didn't work. On day three, I asked production, we got to fix this. And then they called the company, and they said, we're going to pull our business if you don't fix this. And then they said, okay. So they sent out this monster of a trailer.
Look at this thing.
Listen, this is...
that's a normal trailer.
That's the other guy's.
That's
this is
normal,
where the...
This is your trailer.
I know.
It says VIP on the side. What is... How do you live this down?
No, you can't. And like, listen, we have... Like, we had so many actors come through. So we had an Academy Award nominee, you know, Robert Forster come. And he's got like a tiny room there. I have to go and apologize every morning. I'm like, I didn't mean for this to happen.
And they're like, yeah, right. It's in
your
contract.
Exactly,
yeah,
exactly.
Of course. I just love this. Yeah. I want to show everyone a clip. Here's a clip of Small Crimes.
Look, Phil, this is not how I want
One of those young men is in intensive care.
The one with the nunchucks?
His father is an alderman.
Charge me. Those ass on the stand and watch them come apart like wet bread, because you know exactly what this is. They're parked in the middle of nowhere with ninja weapons precisely where and when their girlfriend happens to get assaulted. Like, come on, be serious.
Come on. Nikolaj Coster-Waldau, everybody.